I was shocked by so many people being killed in earthquakes in emerging nations. It was the 2001 earthquake in Gujarat in Kutch, India, that really got my attention. In this event, about 20,000 people were killed, and most people were killed because their stone masonry house collapsed on them. It's not the earthquake that kills people, it's a poorly built building. And this is a man-made problem, so there must be a man-made or a woman-made solution.
Build Change is a social enterprise that saves lives by working with people in emerging nations to build houses and schools so they don't collapse in earthquakes and typhoons.
This model is different from the previous one because mm-hmm. in the previous we used the 2mm plate, which we didn't get locally. So we
first off, we work with governments to develop building standards.
And what about the post bases this time?
Yes, we have a strap coming out.
There's a gap in building code enforcement in most of the emerging world, especially for housing and schools. So the governments may not have the capacity or the budget or the personnel or the vehicles to go out and inspect buildings as they're being built. We're working to fill that gap, doing things like simplifying the building code enforcement so it doesn't take as long for a building inspector to inspect a building, using information technology tools, using apps so that the process is more streamlined. We also provide access to financing. So it's important, especially after a disaster, that a homeowner has access to a grant or a loan to rebuild safely. And usually that's conditional and used as an incentive for people to build safely.
Introducing the three C's of construction. Pahilo C bhaneko chai configuration bhai nai halyo, tes pachadi connection ra tes pachadi chai tapaiko construction quality.
Second, we build capacity. We train everyone in the construction sector, builders, engineers, building materials producers, so that the entire construction industry can elevate its quality. We also do large-scale information campaigns, radio ads, billboards, informing the general public on the basics of safe construction. What simple steps can they take in order to build a disaster-resistant building?
The connection between the beam and column was like this. And during the shaking, it will go like this. And we have teaching them like that. The connection should be like this.
अनि कुन ठाउँमा कस्तो किसिमको जग्गा ठाउँमा घर बनाउनु पर्ने रहेछ भन्ने कुराहरू यसमा हामीलाई त्यो मौका चाहिँ हामीले धेरै नै सुधार्ने मौका यो धेरै बोल्यो हुने रहेछ भन्ने कुराहरू पनि हामीले यस कारणबाट जानकारी पायौँ.
We've helped to shift the industry so that the homeowner can make the decisions. Where is their window? Where is their toilet? Where is their door? What builder do they use? The homeowner drives the process.
Understanding their lifestyle, understanding their needs is very important. For example, for a Nepali household, a porch is a very important space. So all our designs incorporates a porch in front of the house. That's a space where they socialize. That's like kind of a living room area.
मलाई त धेरै बलियो छ जस्तो लाग्छ. अब त ढल्दैन केही हुँदैन जस्तो लाग्छ. मलाई त एकदम खुशी लागिरहेछ.
We have trained over 25,000 people globally in the basics of safe construction, and we have created nearly 11,000 jobs. When the homeowner is in the driver's seat, we are building their confidence that the home will keep them safe. And that's the most important thing after a disaster. That's what enables them to sleep at night and to get back to a normal life.